To pair with AMD's exciting new CPUs, MSI has released a suite of 7 new X570 motherboards. Let's take a look at 3 of the highlights of this new collection. The MEG X570 Godlike, the MEG X570 Ace, and the MPG X570 Gaming Pro Carbon Wi-Fi. Let's start with the creme de la creme, the Godlike. This motherboard is for the PC builder who wants everything. And when we say everything, we really mean it. It's built for hardcore enthusiasts who want to push a system past its normal limits with maxed out overclocking and lots of connectivity. The first thing PC enthusiasts are going to notice comes before you even open the box. Right away, this is a heavy-duty package. The motherboard isn't exactly lightweight, but the package is heavier because the motherboard isn't the only thing you're getting when you pick up the Godlike. You're also getting 2 Pcie Expansion Cards, each one offering a unique service. The first is a 10 gigabit LAN card, allowing you to plug your PC into the best that the internet world has to offer. Sure, most people aren't going to have access to a network of that speed, but if you're serious enough about gaming or online competition to buy this motherboard, there's at least a decent chance you'll have 10 gigabit Ethernet too. And even without the add-in card, the board comes with its own networking capabilities, like its 2.5 gigabit killer LAN and Wi-Fi 6 support. This motherboard can even act as a Wi-Fi extender in your home's networking system. The second expansion card, the Expander Z Gen 4, is an M.2 expansion card, giving you 2 more M.2 slots hooked up to a graphics card level cooling system with its big built-in card fan. Speaking of PCIe connections, this board, like any of the new X570 chipset boards on the market, supports PCIe 4.0 on both PCIe and M.2. And while this new tech is incredibly cool and exciting, it comes with its own new challenges. Thermal throttling, for instance, can hold back certain PCIe 4.0 hardware. With this absolute monster of a board, however, you don't need to worry about that risk because it has one of the most cutting-edge and robust cooling systems we've ever seen in a motherboard. An impressive MSI Frozer heatsink setup surrounds the top of the board and connects to the lower quadrant via an extended heat pipe. Down in that lower quadrant, where the motherboard fan lives, is where the magic happens. The fan is positioned lower on MSI boards like this one than on X570 models from other manufacturers. This lower positioning pulls the important parts of the fan away from the heat of the GPU, prolonging its life. Also, and this is the really cool part, the fan was designed with the same Frozer tech that MSI uses for its GPUs, which means the fan will only turn on when it needs to, which again will prolong life considerably and will cut down on unnecessary fan noise. To stack onto the absolute overkill that is this motherboard, it has a state-of-the-art audio system, including an extreme audio DAC and a 6.1 audio output on the I/O panel. Need to run some high-end audio equipment for your stream, or podcast, or literally anything else? A 6.1 audio output is a rare find on any motherboard. The Godlike currently sits at $699 on Newegg.com, which may be more than some PC builders are willing to spend on a board. For those enthusiasts who still want to overclock and push the limits but don't need all of the add-ons the Godlike offers, there's the MEG X570 Ace, which is currently half the price at $369. The MEG X570 Ace doesn't come with the extension cards that the Godlike has, nor can it support the same absolutely bonkers level overclocking capabilities, but it can still overclock, and it's still built for enthusiasts. Its sleek golden black design encapsulates what this board wants to help you do. Win. The Ace has the same state-of-the-art cooling system as the Godlike, and while it doesn't support 10 gigabit Ethernet on its own, its Intel networking capabilities are fast and powerful. And it also supports the next-gen Wi-Fi 6. Extreme overclocking is still an interesting prospect too, but you'll want to limit yourself to water cooling. If you're using liquid nitrogen, you'll want to step up to the Godlike. This board does have one particular leg up on the Godlike. The Ace actually has 2 more USB ports, which can be significant depending on your build requirements. Last but not least, let's take a look at the X570 Gaming Pro Carbon. This board's sleek design was inspired by supercars, as you can tell by the carbon fiber textures on the two primary heat sinks and the unique design in the top left quadrant of the board. This is the most budget-friendly board of the three that we're looking at today, and as such, it's not built for the same level of enthusiast-grade overclocking. The Gaming Pro Carbon is still a high-performance board, but rather than being built for intense CPU overclocking, it's focused on supporting gaming graphics cards and high-speed SSDs for running modern games with high graphical loads. The cooling on this one is still impressive, but rather than a massive system connected via heat pipe to the rest of the board, the Carbon's cooling focuses more on the lower half of the board, the chipset managing bandwidth to PCIe and M.2 slots. This board also still sports the same reinforced PCI slots that the others have as well, providing maximum safety and reliability for your PCIe 4.0 hardware. If what you're looking for is an eye-catching motherboard built for gaming, complete with RGB underglow, the Gaming Pro Carbon could be the right choice for you. Remember, these are just three of MSI's whopping 7 X570 boards now available. Other models are designed for different use cases, like the Prestige X570 Creation motherboard, which is built with 10 USB slots. You can check out all of MSI's new X570 boards by clicking the links in the description below this video.